昔の私にとっての靴はやっぱりお客さんとして履く側としてただ好きだったっていうもので、今は自分の中ではまあ使命感みたいなものがあって、まあ、歴史に残るような自分にしか作れない靴を作るっていう使命感があるので、靴が作れるっていうことを初めて知って、で私の中にその靴が作れるっていう価値観が入ったことで、単純にちょっとこう興味を持ったというか、私にとっての靴の魅力は機能美から来る靴の形、フォルムの美しさですね。まあ、やっぱりみんなが就職してる中で自分がこう修行、まあ、職人の世界に入るっていうことだったので、とても孤独でしたし、まあ、共感してくれる人がいなかったので、まあ、日々悩みながらこれでいいのかなっていうのは常にこう悩みながら生活してました。非常にこう孤独でしたね。10年弱ぐらい、靴作りを学んできて、まあ、いい靴は作れるようになったんですよね。やっぱりこうそこに自分のオリジナリティっていうのがないなっていうことで、まあ、非常に悩みまして、とても自分の世界が狭かったので海外に行こうと思いました。今まで自分がやってきたような伝統的な靴作りとは全く違う、靴作りをされてたんですね。あ、こういうふうに新しい靴作りに挑戦してる人がいるんだと、こう刺激を受けたというかと思ったんですね。まあ、自分も同じように自分らしい新しい靴を作らなきゃいけないな。ウィーンはあの芸術の街なので、日々こう芸術に触れる機会があったんですね。で私もどんどんこう芸術アートにのめり込んでいって、そこで初めてこう靴とアートを融合させたいなっていうように思いました。靴と芸術を融合させるために、その芸術の部分を、まあ、4年間先生の下で学んできたんですけれども、まあ、そこで学んだ金箔の技術、こんな技術があるんだっていう驚きです。ですぐにこれは靴に絶対に生かせるっていうようなこう感覚を持ちました。高いレベルでこうデザインのラインに自分のこのアートの感覚が生きるようになってきたなと思っていますね、最近。それで最近になって、まあ、ようやく靴作りと芸術アートが高いレベルで、まあ、自分の満足のいく形で融合できるようになってきたかなと思ってます。情熱的で あとは攻撃的で常にこう何かにこうイライラしてるというか、そういったところがあるので、それがエネルギー源となってこんなに時間がかかるようなことを普通だったらやらないっていうところにむしろ挑戦したくなったりしてますね。通常の靴でここヒールこの部分が革のレイヤーでできてるんですね。それと同じやり方でこの作品は作ってるんですね。仕事量で言ったらもう本当に膨大になりますし、アート作品制作はまあ半ば自分のこう勝手にやってるというか、誰のためでもなく自分のためにやってることなので、まあ夜の空いた時間にやる、そういうような位置づけですね。私がデザインを考えるときに、まあ、アイデアをこう思い浮かべるときによく行く場所が、東京の上野公園の中にある国立西洋美術館によく行きますね。単純にそのこの何とも言えないこうシーンとした雰囲気でたくさんの名画に囲まれてっていう環境が好きですね。まあ、それらの名画を見ながら、まあ、歴史を感じながら、自分が今2022年2023年どんな作品を生み出さなきゃいけないか、生み出すべきなのかみたいな感覚になれますね。私にとっての、まあ、人生の目標にもなるんですけれども、歴史に残る全く新しい靴を作るっていうところになります。
제가한8년전에성수동에이게방문했을때이렇게오래된공장들이굉장히많이있는데사람들이없었어요근데제눈에는그게재밌는스토리를만들면재밌겠다사람들이많이올수있겠다하는어떤확신이있어서
근데이제거의젊은인구가많아졌죠
성수동이라는이공간이이제서울에서도조금많이핫해지고
사람들이가장우리가가까이할수있는게무엇일까활성화되고막그생동감넘치는어떤이도시들이존재해가는모습을보면서굉장히뭐행복하죠역시이사람은사람이채워져야되는거나어떤공간이든라든가이제저지붕위에안쪽에서보면50년된거예요그건시간의아름다움이라랄까시간이가지고있는깊이그런것들을가지고있으면서그리고그시간동안에그많은일들이이루어졌을거아닙니까그건물에서그건물의이야기를같이가고싶었어요그래서그이야기속에또새로운이야기를집어넣어서 그게 사람들에게는 더 부드럽게 더 자연스럽게 다가가거든요. 저 지붕이 만약에 제가 페인팅을 하고 깔끔하게 구성을 해놨다면 이쁘긴 하지만 자연스럽게 다가가진 않는 거죠. 사람들 가슴으로.
사실 서울이 제일 큰 부분이 임대료 부분일 거예요. 그래서 그리고 또 중심지보다는 그래서 외곽 쪽으로 많이 좀 분포가 되어 있고요.
이제 두 개 지금 두 개 부서 가지고 나눠서
그거 부분이 이제 운영할 때 가장 어려웠던 부분 같아요. 어떻게 보면은 손재주가 있어야지 목공을 할 수 있다. 뭐 그런 생각을 많이 하시고. 저희도 그래서 어렵게 만드는 가구보다는 쉽게 조립하고 만들 수 있는 가구를 하기 위해서 DIY 클래스를 열고 있습니다. 쉼을 얻고 힐링이 될 수 있다고 생각하기 때문에 어떤 나무를 만지는 요즘 이제 급속도로 우리 디지털 세상이 돼가고 있잖아요. 그러면 반대적으로 아날로그적인 쪽이 필요하게 되거든요.
나는 신발을 엉뚱한 신발을 어려서부터 만들었어요. 그때 우리 선생님이 나한테 하는 말이 야, 그 신발을 누가 신겠냐. 근데 지금 와서 그 신발로 인해 가지고 내가 살아남았어요. 그리고 이제 큰 회사들이 생겨가지고 똑같은 모양을 기계로 뽑아내는 그런 현상이 일어났고 중국에서 대량 신발이, 싼 신발이 들어오니까 자연적으로 도태됐어요. 그 현재 내가 주어진 이 좁은 공간 안에서 나를 찾아주시는 손님들의 신발을 만드는 걸로 만족하고 살거든요. 이 직업에 대해서 지금도 저는 즐기면서 하는데 그 공장에서 지금 이런 곳에서 그냥 가죽 깔고 자면서 배웠어요. 고개 힘이 되어가지고 그 고만할 수가 없어요.
아, 저희 홍대랑 강남 같은 데 놀러 갔었는데 거긴 좀 강했었는데 여기는 좀 이렇게 조용하고 차분하게 같이 놀 수 있어서 좋았던 것 같습니다.
날씨가 괜찮으면 왔다 갔다 하면서 산책도 하고 가게도 찾아다니는 맛이 있어요.
결국은 사람이 제일 중요한데 사람들이 느낄 수 있는 여러 가지 요소들이 이 성수동에는 자리매김하고 있습니다. 늘 이 성수동은 과거와 현재 그리고 미래 이 세 가지가 존재하는 이야기로 재밌게 이렇게 돌아가고 있을 것 같아요.
I would call them my babies. I still remember that magical moment I have when I first, you know, explore my dad's mini compo and his cassette tapes. The first time I put that, you know, the 80s compilation cassette tape into his mini compo, I was kind of blown away by the melodies, the catchy tunes. Since then, I've grew a strong interest for music, and I've decided to, you know, want to pursue more and explore more. I want a record room with a ladder that I can climb up and take a record down and play it. At a time when probably I don't have enough money to buy records, but I know that one day I will want to go into vinyl records. I think the warm sound that the vinyl creates is something that's very special. You can get more punch. I felt vinyls give me a wider dynamic range, typically. Amazing thing about John Peel is that he don't just play the mainstream music, it's really getting the listener to explore obscure music. In his Peel session, some of the artists have been, or bands have been invited to the BBC studio to do a recording, a live recording of their music, and it's typically a four piece of music. So I wanted to own all of them. When you listen to the Peel session, the sound is not so polished. Somewhere between a live version, a raw live version, and the final studio version. I've been looking for vinyls with music I love or with the artwork I love, the Casey Kasem record set. This is really rare. This is the record set that they sent over to radio stations all around the world for the broadcast of this American Top 40 Countdown.
Welcome to American Top 40. I'm Casey Kasem, and this is our...
Every time I put this record on, it just reminds me of my childhood days of staying in my mom's kitchen, listening to Radio Fusion. Records are all housed in crates. This is literally like a real crate digging where you go there and pick up albums from crates. Without knowing what you get today, and then you pull out something and you say, oh no, this is what I've been looking for years.
I'm trying to open my father's musical taste to even wider boundaries. And I got him to buy the Tchaikovsky Violin Concerto vinyl and play at home. And he really enjoys it, so step in the right direction.
Sometimes we do shoot out with my friends, trying to compare the different versions of the vinyl records.
I only can remember my 80s press because my mono or my stereo cut, it sounds a bit like flat. Mm. I'm waiting to hear how it sounds on your mono cut.
When we compare both records, right, like the early one that you got, they pretty much mixed it for like you know, like radio speakers.
It's like people who collect wines, they do blind tests and see which bottle of wine is better. You know, sometimes my friends are serious as well, they take notes, you know, okay, this one has punchier bass, yeah, this sounds brighter, okay, the vocals are more upfront. Vinyl collecting is not just collecting, it's a whole ecosystem, it's a community where all of us share.
All of us come from like a different kind of background, but all of us love a certain kind of range of music. He's got a great collection. I mean, he's not too elitist in his taste because he has his 80s guilty pleasure, but he also very open to the more experimental side of things.
That kind of bonding together with my son, listening to a record, it's like attending a concert together. You don't skip the track, you listen right from the start to the end. Vinyl collecting is more family culture for me. I'm blessed that my son loves music as well, and it is through music and through collecting of vinyl that we get so bonded together.